Welcome back to science class. Today I am here with a new lesson. What is its name? Yes, rocks and minerals. What is it? Rocks and minerals.
Rocks and minerals. Children, have you seen rocks anywhere? Yes, you have seen it on the surface of earth. Only rocks will be present on the surface of earth. No, we can see soil. So, earth is made up of rocks and soil. Okay, children, earth is made up of rocks and soil. Okay, and in your last years, you had studied about the layers of soil. Which are the layers of soil? Yes, topsoil, subsoil. Then, but deep inside the earth, it is mostly rocks. Okay, and rocks can be seen deep inside the earth. Okay, now children see, when you look rocks closer with the help of a magnifying glass, do you know what is magnifying glass? It is just like a lens through which we can see an object more bigger. Okay, so when we look a rock closer, you can see some grains present on the rock. These grains are called minerals. What are they? Minerals. See, minerals. So, what are minerals? Minerals are the solid substances found in nature. Minerals are the solid substances found in nature. And minerals are the building blocks of rocks. Do you know what are building blocks? Yes, you know our body is made up of much more cells. The same way, the rocks are made up of minerals. So, minerals are the building blocks of rocks. Clear? And each rock may have one or more minerals of different colors. Okay, each rock may have one or more minerals of different colors. And I will show you some colored minerals in this rock. See children, this is a type of rock. Can you see some types of colors here? Which all colors are present here? Yes, black, then white, then gray color. Okay, so which you can see different colored, these things are called minerals. So, this rock is made up of the minerals with different colors. Means black, white, then gray color. So, different colored minerals are present in this type of rocks. Now, see, next type of rock. See, this is also a type of rock. See, its color is very beautiful, right? Yes. Yes, blue color. Then, gray color, yes, black, then brown, yes. So, different colored minerals are present in this rock. Okay, now we can see another rock. See children, it's also very beautiful, right? Yes, so which are the colors present here? Yes, white, black, yes, yes, red, yes. Gray color. Okay. So, different colored minerals are present in this rock. Okay. So, now we studied what are minerals. Yes, minerals are the hard substances present on the surface of our earth. And rocks. Rocks are made up of minerals. How can you see the minerals in the rock? Yes, by using a magnifying glass. Okay, and minerals are there of different colors. Even one rock is made up of more than one minerals. Okay, now children, we can see which are the types of rocks. Types of rocks. Okay. Children, by the formation of rocks, how they are formed? By this, we can divide the rocks into different types. Okay, which are the different types of rocks? See, igneous rock. Okay, first type of rock is called igneous rock. Okay, second type of rock is called sedimentary rock. What is it? Sedimentary rock. And the third type of rock is called metamorphic rock. Okay, so which are the types of rocks? First one is igneous rock, then second one is sedimentary rock, and the third one is metamorphic rock. Okay, and now we can study what is igneous rock. You know children, deep inside the earth, you know what can you see inside the earth? Yes, a liquid substance is there. What is it, you know? It is called magma. We told deep inside the earth there will be rocks. But what about the temperature inside? Yes, deep inside the earth the temperature is so high that the rocks can melt there. Melt, what is the meaning of melt? Yes, it can become, it can turn to liquid state. Okay, so this molten material which is present in deep inside the earth is called magma. What is it? Magma. Okay, so here magma gets pushed upward towards the surface of the earth. And you know children, when it reaches to the surface of the earth, it is coming towards our, to the earth, means earth's atmosphere. And what about the temperature in our atmosphere? Yes, it is room temperature. Okay, so what happens to this molten magma? Yes, molten material. Yes, it will turn to solid. When it is, yes, when it is cooling, it will turn to rocks. What happens? It will turn to hard substances. And these hard substances are called rocks. What are they? Rocks. So, in this way, the rocks are formed. Okay, children. So, these types of rocks are called igneous rocks. What are they? Igneous rocks. Okay, now can you tell me how the igneous rock is formed once more? When magma gets pushed upward towards the surface of the earth, it will cool down to form solid rocks again. Okay, these rocks are known as igneous rocks. Okay, see children how the igneous rock is formed? Magma gets pushed upwards towards the surface of the earth, where it cools to form solid rocks again. These rocks are called igneous rocks. Okay, so children, as this magma from inside, this deep inside the earth, comes out of the earth, okay, means to the surface of the earth, what happens? Yes, when it is reaching to the surface, it will cool down. Okay, and when it cools down, what happens? Yes, it will turn into a hard substance. Okay, and this hard substance is called rock. Means here it is called igneous rock. Okay, so this is how the igneous rock is formed. Okay, the formation of igneous rocks. Okay, so here igneous rock is also called fiery rocks. What is it? Fiery rocks. Why is it called fiery rocks? Yes, because it is formed from the molten, yes, magma. It is formed from magma. That's why its name is fiery rocks. Okay, now we can see, children, depending on how the magma cools, sometimes the magma cools slowly under the earth's surface, okay, or sometimes it spills out through cracks in the crust or rushes out from a volcano as lava. Okay, what is lava? Sometimes this magma come out of the crust and it will be in the liquid state itself. Okay, now what happens? Yes, this liquid state which comes out of the earth's crust as liquid state. Okay, this is called lava. What is it? Lava. Okay, and after reaching the earth's surface, the lava cools quickly to form rocks. Okay, after reaching the earth's surface, what happens? This lava will cool to form rocks. Okay, children, lava is a molten rock emerging from a volcano. What is it? Lava is a molten rock emerging from a volcano. Okay, it will be in liquid state. Okay. Depending on the formation of these rocks, we can divide the igneous rock itself to different types. So we can see which are the different types of igneous rocks. First one is granite. What is it? Granite. Okay, do you know how this granite is formed? Yes, when magma cools slowly under the surface of the earth. How is it? When magma cools slowly under the surface of the earth and it is very hard and has large grains. It is very hard and has large grains. Can you see how this there? Yes, this is a granite. And you can see larger grains on it. Because different colored grains you can see on it. Means different types of minerals are present on this granite. Okay, now we can see which are the types of minerals present on this granite. Children, there are three types of minerals. They are feldspar, then quartz and mica. Which are they? Feldspar, yes, quartz and mica. What is the spelling of feldspar? Yes, F-E-L-D-S-P-A-R. That is feldspar. Okay, then second one is quartz. What is it? Quartz. And the third one is mica. Okay, so granite is made up of three types of minerals. They are, yes, feldspar, quartz and mica. Okay, now children, we can see which is the different colored granites. Black, white, then gray color, red is then pink color. Okay, there are different colored granites. Children, you itself might have seen in different types of floors are made up of different colored granites. Okay, now we can see what are the uses of granites. Children, do you know granite is very hard? Because of this property, the uses are also many, many, much more uses are also there. Okay, see, the first use, it is used for making, yes, floors. What are they? Floors. As it is very hard, it can be used for making floors. Okay, second use, it can be used for making statues. Okay, statues. Can you see three statues here? Yes, three statues are there. Yes. Okay, so these are the uses of granites. Because they are very hard, so we can use them for making floors and statues. Okay, children. Now we can see which are the next type of igneous rocks. Okay, second type is basalt. What are they? Basalt. Okay, and basalt is a type of rock which is formed when volcanic lava cools very fast. When volcanic lava cools very fast and hardens quickly. Okay, it is hardening quickly above the surface of the earth. Okay, how the basalt is formed? Basalt is formed when volcanic lava cools very fast and hardens quickly above the surface of the earth. Okay, when it comes in contact with air, what happens? It will cool down. Okay, and it is dark in color. See, did you see its color? It is dark in color. And it is used in construction. Construction means for constructing buildings. Okay, for many purposes we can use basalt. Okay, and these are fine grained. Grain means small minute particle, very minute particles are present on this type of basalt rocks. Okay, and it is glassy also. You know what is glassy? Yes, it is just like a glass piece, shining and all will be there. Okay, so it is used for making, yes, buildings. Okay, and all. I will show you some uses here. See, okay, it is used for making this type of landscape. Okay, and buildings. For these purposes, we can use basalt. Okay, basalt. Okay, and now we can see next type of igneous rock. What is it? It is called obsidian. What is it? Obsidian. Did you see, children? It is very beautiful, right? Okay. And see, children, it is dark colored igneous rock that is formed with magma cools quickly. How is it formed? When magma cools quickly. Okay. So, it is a dark colored igneous rock that is formed when magma cools quickly. Okay, and it is also glassy. Okay, and sometimes very colorful. Can you see different types of color on this obsidian? Yes, very colorful. Okay, and when obsidian is broken, it can form sharp edges, you know, sharp edges. Okay, when you cut a piece of obsidian rock, you can see some sharp edges are formed. I will show you. Yes, this type of sharp edges are formed. Okay, because of this, the ancient humans were used this obsidian to make their tools. Can you see some types of tools here? Yes, different types of knives are there, different types of tools they were made in ancient time. Okay, by using this obsidian. Why they were used? Because when we cut it, they can form some sharp edges. Okay, and okay, now the next type of stone is called, next type of rock is called pumice. What is it? Pumice. Okay, so children, did you see the color of this pumice stone? Yes, it is light colored, right? So it is light colored igneous rock. Okay, it is forming when frothy lava, you know what is frothy lava? Frothy, yes, it is formed just like our soap forms and all, no? This frothy lava cools quickly on the earth's surface. Okay, when this frothy lava comes out of the earth, what happens? When it is contact with air, what happens? It will cool down. Okay, it will cool down, and what is formed? Yes, pumice stone is formed. See, this is called pumice stone. Okay, children. Okay, now as it cools, some types of gases are also present inside them. What happens, you know? Some types of, Yes, what happens? Yes, some types of holes or pockets also will be present in it. Can you see some types of holes in it? Yes. Yes, holes or pocket like structures you can see on it. Okay, so this is just because of the presence of, yes, some types of gases in this, in the magma. Okay, when it comes outside. Okay, so when it hardens with the exposure or with the contact with air, what happens? Yes, it will become hard. But this all holes will be present there. And you do you know, children, it is just like a sponge. When you put it in water, it will float on water. Do you know? It can float on water. And pumice is used to clean our body or as a body scrubber. And it is also used to polish furniture and floors. Okay, so these are the uses of pumice stone. So today we can study only this much, children. Next day we will learn about sedimentary rock, how it is formed and which are the types of sedimentary rocks. Okay, and today what we learned today, we can revise what we learned today. So first of all, we studied minerals. What are minerals? Minerals are the solid substances that can be found in nature. Okay, and we studied magma. What is magma? Yes, magma is the molten material present deep inside the earth. What is magma? Magma is the molten material present deep inside the earth. And next, which are the types of rocks? Yes, igneous rocks, sedimentary rocks and metamorphic rocks. Okay, and today we studied about the formation of igneous rocks. And are you remembering how the igneous rock is formed? Yes, when the magma gets pushed upward towards the earth's surface, where it cools to form solid rocks again. And this type of rocks are called igneous rocks. What are they? Igneous rocks. Okay. Now we studied about different types of igneous rocks. Which are they? Yes, granite. Then basalt. Then obsidian. And the last one is pumice. We studied the formation of this type of rocks. And we also studied about their uses. Okay, children, today this much about today's class, and we will meet with a new topic on next class. Okay, so children, bye bye, children. Thank you.